establishing a government of existence, we can prevent the mission using our resources, practices, and maxims. We are able to be aligned in the world, but our lives seem to be living with the same people. Sometimes we also are self-aware thinking, I am doing my best, I am a good priest. The problem is not me, but others.
The problem is not me, but others. This defense sounds logical, except that it is based on a dangerous misunderstanding of the real nature of the crisis we are facing today. The integrity crisis involves not just other people or other priests. The integrity crisis involves us all. For in the body of Christ, we belong to one another, we affect one another, we cannot escape one another. St. Paul wrote, if one member suffers, all the members suffer with it. If one member is honored, all the members rejoice with it. Whether we like it or not, for better or for worse, we are all connected. Sin, even the most primary, destroys community. How do we regain our personal integrity? Let us read the words of Jesus and reflect on it. Can you truly say that God is enough for you? Are you not perhaps desperately seeking treasures that satisfy but do not fulfill your deepest needs?
A person with integrity has a single mind, single outlook that leads you in the right direction. Outward determines not outward, but outward mind is a person. Are our eyes fixed on what God wants us to be and do? What is our mocking or doing what we are doing? How much time do we waste on things such as us? How much time do we invest in God? A person with integrity is a single way. He seeks to serve as one's master. Nobody can serve successfully two masters. To attempt to do so is to become occupied by the person that they might have in heart. Divided mind and divided will, the present of crown of boldness is the source of hypocrisy.
Are we hypocrites? Hypocrisy is lying to other people. Soon we start lying to ourselves. Hypocrisy always leads to duplicity. When pretense becomes a habit, lying becomes our way of life, and we no longer see anything wrong with it. Where does this end? When lying to others and lying to oneself have taken over, integrity is eroded and even destroyed. The result is apostasy. We make God a liar and our life becomes darkness. St. John writes, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we say we have not sinned, we make God a liar and his word is not in us. Lord,
teach us to be honest with ourselves.